Hello, my name is Alan Fader, and I am a principal data scientist at Invesco. My talk today is about categorical embeddings and the embed package in R. If you are trying to create a predictive model, you'd really like to use all of the variables in your data set, as that's what's likely to create the most accurate and successful predictions. But you may soon run into a problem, because many of the functions within R that are used to create these models require that all of the input data are continuous numbers. Now, this makes sense because many of the computations that go on in the background work on linear algebra and matrices, which inherently can only have numbers in them. But that might be a problem for you because some of your data might be categorical variables and you don't want to have to drop them. You might try to replace each category with a number, 1, 2, 3, which might work if your data is ordinal, but if your data doesn't have any inherent order to it, this might not work. If one of your categories is color, how are you going to choose numbers for black, brown, yellow, or green? You might try to create dummy variables, but this actually can cause big data problems really quick. Dummy variables will create a new variable for each level of your data. And for example, if one of your categories is United States zip code, you're about to add 42,000 new variables to your data, and that's probably not what you want. That leads me to categorical embeddings. If you're familiar with word embeddings, such as word2vec, this is actually a very similar idea, except instead of an embedding for each word in language, you're embedding each category in your data. What happens is that every category is replaced by a vector of numbers. The vector can be length 4, it can be length 50, it really depends on the situation. But these numbers will replace your categorical variable for any future modeling. Now, categorical variables are most commonly fit by neural networks, which is why within R, many of the most common ways of creating them are using the Keras or TensorFlow packages or the new Torch package. However, I find the simplest way to do it is with the embed package, which is one of the add-on packages in the TidyModels suite of packages. For example, let's say you had a data set of sales transactions and you wanted to predict which transactions are fraudulent and which ones are not. Having product in there, you can imagine how that would help the predictive ability of the model, but with over 4,500 unique products, that's going to cause problems with creating your model. But with the embed package, all you have to do is add one function step embed onto a TidyModels recipe to create this embedding. Once you've prepped this recipe, the embeddings are there for use. And you can see here how each product is now represented by an embedding of 4 numbers. And these 4 numbers are going to replace the old product category within the data going forward. You can now use this for any downstream model. It doesn't even have to be a neural network. You could also use this, if you wanted, just to explore your data further and learn more about the products. Maybe you could use cosine similarity to figure out which products are most similar to each other. Now, there's obviously a ton more that I could talk about with categorical embeddings. It's a topic that I find really exciting. I hope you learn and discover more about categorical embeddings as you use them within your modeling. Thank you very much for coming, and good luck.